プレオソロン、今体直すインプレオソロンだとか、ということ。コピラは幻覚されて幻覚の得意である。名残ミトコンデリアでのものです。
自分には自分の生き方というかの
テレンバン、
まあ、自分なりにしかやっぱり生きれないじゃないですか。
と今日もまだ体調か。ワンセルウォッチっていうのは使えないですか。ワンセルウォッチ、時計のウォッチ、ワンセル。
山の斜面には亡くなった方々の墓標が並んでいます。この墓標を見ていますと、事故が起きた直後からまるで時間が止まっているような錯覚にとらわれ、30年という長い年月が経ったとは思えなくなります。今回私たちが番組で取り上げた番組の医師たちは、その30年という長い間、親の死をきっかけに自らの生き方を繰り返し追い続けてきました。事故では520人が犠牲となり、その何倍もの数の遺族の方々も突然家族が失われた現実と向き合い続けてきました。
拡大によると DNA の様子、ちょっと今日も休み
です。30年目の8月12日を
迎えます。今日はデジタルカメラの研究です。デジタルカメラ昨日買ったやつです。100円です。
これが大プールだ。その中でもおすすめが巨大スライダーだ。
これがいいです。このサイズがいいです。
今回の NHK スペシャルは、熱天気候で青森に引っ越し出した時点で、危険な火山島から小笠原の安全な島へ、新たな発信地に世界初の言わざるを得ました。
George Daly, our speaker, is going to present to us some new and exciting data, some of which you might have seen a little buzz about in the last few days. For a really interesting and informative scientific seminar. George is the Samuel E. Lux IV Professor of Physiology. He's also the director of the Stem Cell Transplantation Program at Children's Hospital, and he is professor of biological chemistry and molecular pharmacology. neurology and pediatrics brought from Harvard Medical School. He has obtained the MD and the PhD from Harvard and MIT, respectively. He has an internship in medicine and a postdoctoral fellowship, all of those in Boston. Has been a very productive faculty member since that time, including an appointment as an investigator in the Howard Hughes Medical Center in 2008. Elected to the ASDI. And he and I are particularly proud of being able to point to the fact that he was one of the first pioneer award winners of our first class in 2004. Point to his achievements and that of some of those other pioneer award winners in the what a successful program that has turned out to be. Not only someone who has led the scientific enterprise himself, but is very much willing to spend some of his time as well. From a policy perspective, has been articulate and effective interface in terms of talking with the public, with the Congress, with other decision makers about what the opportunities are here and also about important policy decisions. He's been a real friend to KNIH over the course of the past years. He spoke to the Institute directors at a recent leadership forum. It was a wonderful opportunity to be able to get his training. And he continues to be very helpful in advising us about our plans in the interval program here to make a real focus on inclusionary focused stem cell. By the recruitment of a director for a center that will focus particularly on the efforts to move this really exciting science in the direction of clinical application. So, George, we're really grateful for the time and effort you've put into advising us, and we're thrilled that you're here today. Please welcome George Daly.
Thank you. Don't forget Dempsey Study Section. It's always an absolute thrill to come to NIH. I have to say that, every time I'm in Washington, it's very, very special. And I felt a real sense of excitement when I met with a number of your postdocs for lunch, that there are new and creative ways that the community is thinking about exploiting this new and incredibly exciting technology around cellular engineering and inclusionary processing. And my goal today is to tell a number of stories about how we're approaching the biology of reprogramming and inclusionary processing and using it not only, but initially to explore this fascinating biology of turning a cell back from its specialized state into a reprogrammed pluripotent cell. But I'll also talk about some of the lessons we've learned about the limitations of disease modeling and the fact that there are still valuable lessons to be learned from modeling using embryonic stem cells and indeed valuable lessons to be learned from reprogramming through somatic cell nuclear transfer. So the stem cell concept has found its way into medicine for decades. Hematopoietic stem cell transplantation is one of the great triumphs of modern biomedicine, and indeed we have curative therapies, but there are significant limitations, and applications outside of the hematopoietic system are limited, and I think that's where much of the promise of stem cells are.
DoD News Web Update. Defense Secretary Ash Carter has been on the move for the last few days handling important matters throughout the Middle East. Sergeant Luther Washington is here with us right now to tell us more.
This guy stays busy 24/7. Secretary of Defense Ash Carter has been traveling to different parts of the world, meeting with officials, discussing the ISIL threat. If you head over to YouTube and search under DoD News, there's a short video highlighting what Secretary Carter has been up to in bringing attention to this issue. Carter says achieving ISIL's lasting defeat